Dixon has been one of the most watched marginal seats. It's been held by Home Affairs Minister Peter Dutton since 2001. But when he suggested his Labor opponent was using her disability as an excuse, it backfired badly. Ailey France, an amputee, sees the opportunity to echo the concerns of the electorate about the National Disability Insurance Scheme.
The big issue with the NDIS at the moment is that not enough people are getting plans that actually deliver the services and the support that they need.
The minister was eventually forced to publicly apologise for his comments. The NDIS problems have become a key issue for many voters. Not only did the last federal budget underspend allocated funds by around $1.5 billion, disability support groups say there are lots of problems even accessing the scheme.
So we're hearing people that have got real concerns about the NDIS, the rollout of the NDIS, their inability to access services or when approved for services, to actually get services and receive support.
2.5 years after the NDIS rollout, some Queenslanders still don't know if they are eligible to access the scheme.
Delays in implementation are meaning far less Queenslanders are accessing the scheme than expected, leaving a strain on less appropriate services.
Bill Shorten has now pledged to protect the funds if elected, as he believes the underspend highlights the current government's lack of attention to disability.
You know, government, in inverted commas, saves money? No, they don't.
Advocates want urgent attention, whoever wins power.
And we'd be also asking that with the Royal Commission, that we not wait till the end of the process to start making the changes that are required, that as the changes are identified, that government takes the lead and addresses the issues that are being raised in the Royal Commission.
Georgie Hewson, QUT News.